Pulaski Jane Doe. On May 25, 1981, a local resident was going to collect gravel from the creek bed along the highway outside of the small town of Dixon, Missouri. This is when he came upon a woman partially submerged in water. The police were called to the scene and determined that she had only been dead for about 4 or 5 hours. Since this location was very out of the way, authorities believed that it was likely it was a local who knew the area that was the perpetrator. A graduation party was recently held very close to the dump site the night before. All of the attendees of the party were questioned. However, no one admitted to having seen her there. The Pulaski Jane Doe was speculated to have been between 25 and 40 years old. She was beaten and strangled to death with pantyhose. Her race was undetermined, but possibly white with Native American or Hispanic heritage. Over the years, they had her body analyzed, determining she was likely born in the United States and probably lived in Missouri for a few years. She had dental work on her lower teeth in addition to a full upper dental plate. Her bra had either the words Jubal or Julie written inside. Despite all of the efforts over the years to identify her, nothing worked until this year when genetic genealogy cracked the case. In April 2019, detectives submitted Jane Doe's DNA to the DNA Doe Project. Donations had been collected over the next year in order to fund the project. Using genetic genealogy to identify relatives through DNA, the research finally led to her brother. When investigators reached out to him, he said that he does have a sister and that he had lost touch with her in the early 1980s. After submitting a sample, the two became an official match. And just like that, after 40 years, the Pulaski Jane Doe got her name back. She was officially identified as Karen K. Nippers. Police are still seeking her murderer. The Sand Canyon John Doe. For the past 2 years, Major Crime Division of the Lyon County Sheriff's Office has been actively investigating the unsolved murder of an unknown Caucasian male whose body was discovered on May 12, 1992, in Sand Canyon, the southern portion of Lyon County, Nevada. The body remained unidentified for nearly 30 years since his death and has only been known as the Sand Canyon John Doe ever since. Then in late 2020, the LCSO Major Crimes Division, working with Parabon Nanolab Snapshot out of Virginia, along with CeCe Moore, who is its chief genetic genealogist, tracked down a list of potential family members using genetic matches from GEDmatch. In August, they were able to positively confirm the identity of the murder victim as 43-year-old Vincent Marion Trapp. He was originally from Sacramento, California. So many of these murderers go unsolved because without knowing who someone is, it's hard to identify the why and how. After identifying Vincent Trapp, LCSO Major Crimes detectives traveled to 2 different states to interview persons of interest, and they were able to establish a rudimentary timeline of his general whereabouts leading up to his death. The exact date when Vincent Trapp moved to Nevada from California is unknown, but it is known that he lived in Douglas County at the Topaz Ranch Estates in late 1989 through the fall of 1990, and he was the resident of Lyon County in the spring of 1991. It is believed that Vincent Trapp was murdered sometime between spring and summer of 1991. Currently, the Lyon County Sheriff is asking for the public's assistance in any information regarding Vincent Trapp's murder. If you know anything that could shed light on this case, please contact the number on your screen. The Durham, North Carolina Jane Doe. People clearing out a storage unit in October 2016 got an unexpected surprise and found themselves having to call the police. Investigators were shocked to find the skeletal remains of a young woman in a container found within the storage unit in North Carolina. The skeletal remains were found inside of a plastic container tucked inside the unit. It was unclear at the time how long the remains had been inside that location. Prior to their discovery, the unit was rented by the same person since 2010, at which time that was 6 years. The death was ruled suspicious, however, there was little evidence to either identify her or identify what killed her, much less how she ended up in the storage unit. In February 2019, a composite sketch of Jane Doe was released. This was in hopes that someone would recognize her and come forward with information. The sketch depicted a young woman with shoulder-length hair, a slight space between her front teeth, and they were broadcast in the news and posted on missing persons sites. Unfortunately, according to the police, no leads were forthcoming. Jessica Poitra disputes this, however. She said she went to the police because she had suspicions that the Jane Doe was her sister after the sketch came out. At this time, Missy had been missing for more than 10 years. The woman had the same gap in her teeth as my sister did, and we just knew it was her, Jessica told Native News Online, but the police wouldn't believe us. The case went cold until the year 2020, when the private lab authoring learned of this case and offered to assist the Durham Police Department with the use of advanced DNA testing and forensic genealogy. Because such DNA testing is expensive, a DNA Solves crowdfunding campaign was started to offset some of the costs. The Durham Police Department funded the remainder of the cost in an attempt to expedite the identification. Othram used forensic-grade genome sequencing to produce a genealogical profile, and then the research phase began. At the time, there were very few matches, and there were none closer than a second cousin. Genetic and genealogical analysis suggested the woman was from the Turtle Mountain Band of the Chippewa tribe. Othram returned candidate relationships to Durham Police Department, and then the investigation continued from there. The Durham Police Department got DNA swabs from the family they believed she belonged to, and the identification was eventually made. It turns out her name was Melissa Ann Poitra, who went by the name Missy. Missy's family had been clear that they didn't give up. Missy's daughter, Brittany Hetland, is now 27 years old, and she was only 10 when her mother went missing. She said she had long been calling the Durham Police Department, begging them to conduct a DNA swab to test for a possible match in the Durham's Jane Doe. Eventually, when the DNA was processed, the Durham Police Department reached out to Missy's father to match his DNA sample against the remains of Jane Doe in North Carolina. It was a match. The family had finally found Missy. While she has been laid to rest, her exact cause of death and her killer has yet to be identified. Hope you enjoyed today's Jane and John Doe stories. Please hit the like and subscribe button if you haven't yet. Take care of yourself and each other.